Jonathan Toews, Patrick Kane, and the Blackhawks are in L.A. and on a mission to match the energy and intensity of the reigning Stanley Cup champs. And while Daryl Sutter may not believe in momentum, Justin Williams, Jonathan Quick, and the Kings have it. Tonight, they'll attempt to even up the series at two games apiece. Los Angeles, California, home to beautiful movie stars, gorgeous models, and the hottest home team in playoff hockey. We are getting set for Game 4 of the Western Conference Final. And with that, we welcome you into NHL Live, Lee McHugh, alongside Mike Milbury and Keith Jones. So the biggest story in hockey as we get ready for this game is probably going on back east, and that is Pittsburgh, the preseason favorite to win the Cup, now down 3-0 in the Eastern Conference Final. How do you think the two teams that are playing tonight feel about the fact that the Pens could soon be out of this?
I think they're probably excited about it, but if you watch the way the Boston Bruins are playing, I don't know that you're doing jumping jacks. The Bruins have played really Western Conference-style hockey, good, sound, defensive hockey, and their top players have been very productive. It's a great formula for success and a great formula to win a Stanley Cup. I'd be a little concerned about the Bruins if I was in the West.
Any of these teams that are thinking about anything but what's happening tonight is not in a good place for me. So the focus goes to the team that's focused on their tilt in a couple of hours, an hour.
Kings, they're definitely focused because they are down a game. But if they look completely comfortable tonight, it's because they are back on home ice. L.A. 8-0 at home during this postseason. When you look at the 1-7 road record, considering they were 10-1 on the road in the last playoffs, and they're outscoring their opponents at home 21-9. That penalty kill at home has been outstanding. We do know that L.A. will again be without Mike Richards. He's still recovering from a concussion. And now the Blackhawks are down a key cog. Defenseman Duncan Keith suspended for tonight's game for, well, I guess you'd have to say removing some of Jeff Carter's teeth, using his hockey stick to do it. Carter, he hacks him a few times. Keith obviously retaliates. He is suspended for one game. It occurred Tuesday night, second period of game 3. So, Carter's okay. Keith is not. Keith's out. What are they going to miss?
Yeah, they're missing a lot. They're missing a lot of key minutes, penalty kill, power play. The Blackhawks have scored 40 goals in the playoffs, 20 of them Duncan Keith's been on the ice for. He generates a ton of offense. He's a terrific skater. He's got some good offensive instincts. Play is at both ends of the ice, though, and his wheels are what they're going to miss the most. He can flat out fly. Watch him jump in here, pinching down, causing all kinds of problems for the forecheckers on the LA Kings. And any forward that's trying to get the puck out of the zone has to have their head on a swivel when Keith is out there. There'll be more room for the LA Kings without number 2 in red, and that's a big plus for the Kings. You can see how elusive he can be, outstanding through the first 3 games of this series, and he will be dearly missed on the back end. Offense from the back end is provided primarily from Duncan Keith for Chicago, and it's some big skates to fill for the rest of the members of their blue line.
And they don't really have a guy that's just going to step in and fill that.
No, they don't.
We know it's Sheldon Brookbank is going to get the go tonight. So individually, who's feeling a little bit more pressure tonight?
Brent Seabrook is a workhorse for the Chicago Blackhawks, and there's no doubt that his ice time is going to come up. It's like that little girl in the commercial. More is better, right? More, more, I want more. That's what he's going to get tonight. Tons of ice time. He's strong. He can shoot the puck. He can block shots. He hits. He's fearless. This is a terrific hockey player. He's averaging just under 21 minutes a game. I would expect him to pick up 4 or 5 minutes at least. It looks like he's going to be paired with Nicholas Jarmelson, a guy that can skate and can add more minutes to his time. I would see them on the ice almost half this hockey game.
Speaking of pairings, Keith out, Brookbank is in. He will be paired with Nick Leddy. As for the state of the Blackhawks defense, Brian Engblom caught up with Johnny Oduya.
All right, Johnny, you'll be playing without the services of Duncan Keith tonight because of the suspension. What does that mean for you as part of the defense corps and your team?
Obviously, he's a good player, key player, tough to replace. But I think for the rest of us on the back end there, just, you know, it's going to be a little bit more more minutes. I think we have good depth, and Brooks is going to come in now, and you know, he's been playing the whole year, done a tremendous job. So just a better effort from all of us as a group. I think we are.
You lost game 3. You're still up in this series. What do you have to clean up in this game 4 here from the last loss?
Well, we felt we didn't play our best last game. The start was something that we didn't really it didn't really play out the way we wanted to. You know, I think key today always is going to be the start. And then, you know, play a solid game. You know, put some pressure on them and have a good forecheck. I think that's going to be key too. Same thing as we did at home. We know they're a good team. We know they're very good here at home. We have to be at our best if we want to win.
They changed some of their lines around, some of their centers. How did that change the way you defended against them?
It didn't change too much. I think our matchup kind of stayed somewhat the same. You know, it's tough to juggle it around too much, especially on the road. You have the change there. They got the first change. So, you know, I think for us it's just trying to roll our lines, play the deep pairings, you know, evening up as much as we can, and just get everybody in through the game. I think that's going to be key. Yeah.
Thanks, Johnny.
No problem.
All right, so when you have Brookbank instead of Keith, obviously it's a huge step back, but where's it going to be most noticeable?
In the speed of the game and how quickly the Blackhawks are able to move pucks out of their zone. Nick Leddy will play with Brookbank, one of the best skating blue liners for the Chicago Blackhawks. Probably a good move by Joel Quenneville. He'll make up for some of the deficiencies that Brookbank has. Brookbank is a physical, hard-working player, but he is no Duncan Keith.
I give the guy credit. 6 years, full years in the minor leagues before he finally cracked the lineup. But this is a fringe NHL player who can play tough, yes. I would dump it at his corner, make him handle it. That's what the LA Kings like to do, is dump and chase and forecheck. They'll know where to put it tonight.
Two guys who are going to be on the ice for Chicago who need to step up if they're going to move on are these two guys, Jonathan Toews, Patrick Kane. When you look at when they won the Cup back in the 2010 postseason, they combined through 15 games for 14 goals, 30 assists, 44 points. But this year, look at the drop-off. 3 goals, 14 assists, 17 points. When you look at these two guys, what doesn't look right about them?
Well, the point totals don't look right, obviously, but this guy's not shooting as much. He looks tentative. He's usually cocky, borderline arrogant, but that's absent his game. It happens when you don't have production. I think he's just got to continue to shoot the puck. This guy's seeing a lot of attention, some whispers that maybe he's not 100%. After hits like that, you'd expect him to be bumped and bruised a little bit. He keeps on coming, but the productivity has not been there. I don't know how this team wins a Stanley Cup with their two top offensive producers functioning at this rate. It seems highly unlikely that they're going to get to another Stanley Cup without them doing more offensively. And tonight would be a good night for them to jump into the mix.
Is it as simple as just telling these guys to be more aggressive or to shoot more or to shoot from certain areas?
I don't think so. I think it comes down to a little bit of puck luck. In the case of Jonathan Toews, you saw the video that Mike just showed. There's some energy and effort to his game. He's going to bounce back every time he gets knocked down. For Patrick Kane, he needs a point. He needs to get that cockiness back that Mike talks about. When he's dangling, putting it through a guy's skates, walking around him, those spinoramas that we saw so often. But it's no easy task against the LA Kings in the way that they defend. That's the challenge for those players. And sometimes you just got to push through and start being productive by getting pucks to the net and going those high traffic areas.
Perhaps one reason that they're two wins away from the Stanley Cup final, despite the poor performance by those two stars, is that the Kings can relate to their plight. Of course, LA, they won the Stanley Cup last year, and Andrei Kopitar and Dustin Brown were the catalyst. You look at the 14 goals, 18 assists, 32 points through 16 games. Major drop off for these guys as well. 5 goals, 6 assists, 11 points for them. You know, it was interesting. Early in the playoffs, we talked about a guy like Brad Richards and the Rangers and Rick Nash and how they weren't performing. Are you seeing any similarities, or are these guys bringing other things to the table?
They bring other things, but Kopitar's struggling mightily. Brown, you always know he's going to be physical and hitting guys. The LA Kings are fortunate that Jeff Carter's in the mix. He's playing as the number one center in the way he's played over the last 2 games, and he's been productive. Depth up the middle of the ice certainly comes in handy at playoff time. We've seen it with the Boston Bruins. There's no question about how dominant they've been because of their top two centermen. Carter has played that type of hockey. He's been gritty. He's been irritating. It's the type of hockey we don't see a lot from Jeff Carter, but he's done it in the playoffs and paid a price for it there. Jumped back out, ended up picking up a bunch of stitches and losing some teeth, but still was productive in the game with a couple of assists. He's done a really good job in helping out to Foley and his adjustment to playing in the National Hockey League. Penner has also been good on that line. And he's out there in key situations. At the end of the game, Daryl Sutter is confident enough to put him out there to defend, and he helps the team out there in getting an assist on the empty net goal.
Should this guy be a center all the time?
I don't know. I think they can afford to put him back to the wing when Richards is in. Richards is certainly more of a natural centerman. His size and strength and his willingness to shoot, you know, puts him on the wing, but he sure looks pretty good right now at that position.
We are just getting started here on NHL Live. Meanwhile, back in Los Angeles, Johnny Oduya, he's quick. He's in an interview in a suit. 1 second, he's in shorts, getting his equipment ready for game time. The next. As for the things back east, the Pens, they were the favorites to capture the cup, but they've run into the buzzsaw that is the Boston Bruins. After a double overtime thriller in Beantown, Pittsburgh finds itself on the verge of early elimination. We'll drill down on the Eastern Conference Final after this.